Air coatings. We'll start off with those, known as anti-reflective coatings, some of the most widely used and most popular coatings in the industry. Edmund Optics has 10 specific AR coatings that cover deep into the UV, throughout the visible, and into the infrared wavelengths, out to shortwave infrared. The top graph here goes over the actual spectral range that we have, and the bottom graph is more specific to give you the actual performance metrics on a variety of V-coats, where the coating falls on, where it falls off, and where the optimal performance ranges are. Metallic mirrors, we won't touch on them too much today, but they're worth mentioning because they are great in terms of applications that are polarization sensitive. So metallic mirrors and coatings are exactly what you think they are. Metallic deposited material onto a metal or glass substrate. Most commonly, aluminum, silver, or gold is used, and these allow you to reflect and utilize wavelengths all the way down the UV, all the way out to infrared beyond 20 microns. Dielectric mirrors, one of my favorites, and some of the most advanced coatings out there in the industry. These are extremely broadband or narrow, depending on the layering technique or the manufacturing method. These also can be very discrete in the types of wavelengths that they're used. So they can cover all the way down to extremely deep UV wavelengths, as far as 120 to 150 nanometer range, depending on the materials used. Very popularly used in the visible wavelengths and IR, and really starting to push the boundaries out into far infrared wavelengths in the shortwave and midwave bands. Beam splitter filters, much like a standard beam splitter, these are used to control polarization ratios and transmission or reflection ratios, anywhere from 10 to 90% transmission and reflection, all the way up to 90-10. Some of the most popular would be a 50-50 style beam splitter, and these are available in plates, in cubes, in films, in a variety of different materials with metal wire grids embedded into them. Extremely thorough offering here at Edmund Optics, and extremely popular technology in a variety of applications. We're going to talk more about different styles of filters and start off with edge filters. So these can be long pass, short pass, hot or cold mirrors. And what they do is allow you to transmit and block specific wavelengths. So on one side, you could block UV wavelengths and pass only visible and IR wavelengths. Or with a short pass style filter, you could transmit UV and visible wavelengths while blocking IR wavelengths. Bandpass filters, think of this as two edge filters stacked together, or a bandpass, which they're more commonly known as. These can be extremely broadband, these can be extremely narrowband, depending on the application you're using. A lot of LEDs would use a style of broadband filter, anywhere from 100 to 200 nanometers, covering the full visible spectrum. These are very tightly controlled with center wavelength, bandwidth, or full width half max, and they can be very tightly controlled with the cut-on and cut-off wavelengths. Laser line bandpass filters can be extremely tightly controlled as well, with center wavelengths across the entire UV, visible, and IR spectrum, with full width half maxes on the order of less than 1 nanometer. So how do you define a coating, or how do you justify a coating? Well, AR coatings, very easy. The cost is pretty much nullified in your entire system and can be a few dollars onto a standard substrate. If you consider a BK7 glass substrate, you're going to lose roughly 4% of light per surface. So if you have a stacked assembly of 2 or 3 lenses, you're going to lose roughly 16 to 24% of your light overall. Air coating can reduce this to less than 0.5%. So your system integrity is kept intact, and you're achieving the optimal transmission and performance that you designed your system to work for. Filters are being integrated more and more as applications demand them. So biomedical and biophotonic systems are absolutely demanding these styles of filters. The medical field and healthcare field continues to grow as the human population continues to grow and get older, and we need to be able to manipulate certain wavelengths of light for sensitive detection and imaging systems. Certain wavelengths of light are not toxic or non-harmful to our body. These are more commonly known as near-infrared or IR wavelengths. Regardless of the coating type that you use, the manner that you specify them can be tightly controlled on a precision side or very loosely controlled on the commercial side of things, and cost is really the justification for deciding on one or the other. So from a high level comparison sense, we'll look at AR coatings and filter coatings. Typically an AR coating is less than 10 layers, whereas a dichroic filter is greater than 10 layers and takes a much longer time to coat. In terms of the optical monitoring in the actual manufacturing process, it's much easier and quicker to accurately monitor your coating layering and your coating performance on the AR side, where on the filtering and dichroic side, you need very precise optical monitoring systems. Tolerances on the AR side can be relieved over the broadband extended range, whereas a tighter tolerance is applied to dichroic filters. AR coatings are less sensitive to the chamber geometries, pressures, and temperatures, whereas a dichroic filter really meets specific guidelines on how the chamber is heated up or how it's cooled down. And last but not least, there's a variety of ways in which you can manufacture an AR coating, whereas a dichroic filter, there's really only a handful of methods that you can use to actually create, design, or manufacture these types of optics.